Hey, good morning, guys. How's it going? More Breath of the Wild, of course. I do have some things. So me and Kayla have some things that are planned for later. So, not sure if I'm going to be streaming later. I'm definitely going to be streaming now, and probably for quite a while. And let's continue. I started heading to one of the divine beasts, and I'm not sure I actually want to do that yet. I might engage in some of this story stuff early on, and then I might back off and go back to just exploring for a little bit. Like no food. You know what I really should have done before I started streaming was just mass produce some food, but nothing to do that. Get dishes. Not really. No, I don't. Oh man. Yes, I guess for now this is probably gonna have to do. No arrows. Man, I'm just not in a good situation to be here, like at all. Where is this? Okay, so it's marked. As long as it's marked, I think I'm just gonna back away for a minute. Okay, this my map looks so fucked up. Very weird path to take. Where are we gonna go? The Great Plateau, right? We'll go south. Hold on a second, guys. A long load screen. So my capture card, if you not cached previous Zelda streams, been having some issues, unfortunately. I'm getting some freezing here and there. It's really easy to fix midstream, thankfully. I've contacted Razer about this, to which I have not had a reply. So might have to return it and replace it completely. Now, what I should have really done. Gone someplace just to. Whoa, I don't want to do that. We got like a. This works. You guys might hear me sipping on my coffee. I apologize. It's pretty early. Think I'll take the time early in the stream. Just to kind of cook up a couple of meals. I don't think I'm gonna make it very far if I don't. Not sure what I have here. Really wish there was a much easier way to do this. say faster. Spell it very hard. It skipped a little music, but I almost feel like it's not even worth it. Watch the show. I'll show you. Really don't save much time. Suppose a little. Hey, we got some more of these. Next, I'm probably gonna need some arrows. We just keep running out of those. Stamina food is so good. Man, I don't even really have a whole lot to cook now, do I? I think that's gonna do it. Oops. Need three more shrines for an upgrade. I don't really need to. Gotta seek some stuff out here. You have so much. When you get to the end of the game, you have so much rupees, so many rupees. Starting out, it's actually, I forgot how rough it is starting out in this game. Alright, let's see. I was heading south. It'd be this way. Down here. Oh, that's right. I'm running really low on weapons, too. Hey, it's Dragon. What? That's a strong-ass fox. I want to check out this tower thing up here. Some weapons and stuff. It's raining. I'm surprised I'm not climbing. Search these things. Some pretty epic lightning right there. Oh, hey. Chest over here somewhere. Was that a bow? Probably why I haven't already grabbed it. Thank you. Ooh. Sneak up on this guy. Hey, arrows. Oh man, this thing is weak. Oh, nice. So many weapons. Definitely do away with this. I never use the boomerangs ever. You see me? Behind a tree. Ah, there we go. Don't turn around. Don't turn around. There we go. Oh. up these guys, I think, in the last stream. I don't think you mean omelet. Maybe they'll do it again. Oh, nice. Food out here? Been pretty fruitful, actually. Oh, fuck. God damn it. Try to get that fucker. Hey, shrine. Oh, I didn't want that. I actually wanted the sword. Yeah, of course. Phew. This breaks so quickly. I don't think it's really worth having. Oh. I didn't realize they were there. I really want to use my good food. A lot of archers. Guess I got the arrows I wanted. See what's up here. First playthrough, I totally did not utilize sneak enough. It's actually really, really helpful. Be a totally different train. Or not. Oh. Hello. Oh, that's an interesting place over there. I don't think I've been over there. I'm just getting attacked by everything. Tell who wears the pants in this family. Is constantly breaking. I'm totally not opposed to the fact that weapons break in this game. I'm really not. A lot of people find it aggravating. I'm of the team that I believe that it makes it so that you know, you have to use a variety of weapons and think about what you're doing a lot more. That being said, I think they definitely break a little too easy. Yeah, they are. Welcome, Pyro. They are expendable. You know, it's not a huge deal. It just sort of sucks that I feel like when you go into a goblin encampment or bokoblins, I suppose, in this game, and you have like five people to fight, and your broadsword breaks fighting five of them. I just think it's a little excessive. I'm totally on board with the whole idea. I like it. I really do, overall, but I'd like to see him just, you know, just last a little bit longer. Ooh. What if I kill you? Hey, I remember this place. I take it you've played the game, Pyro? So slow. Yeah, it's so good. Did you just get it? If you don't mind me asking. You had it for a while now? I got it with the Switch launch, and just doing a second playthrough now. I just basically started over because, you know, I didn't want to stream the end of my game. I don't know what to pick here. Let's go grab another one of these. There we go. I really like these Guardian Swords. Nice. Did you get it with a Switch? Wii U? Hey, I used that, to fight the Lionel. I don't know why I hang on to these. I really never use them. I'm actually gonna drop this, I think. I use the fire one sometimes, just to, like, start a fire if I need to, but lightning one pretty much never gets used. Let's see, Oh, you got the Pro Controller. I was really, yeah, there are new things everywhere. It's a pretty crazy world to explore. I find that the Switch controller is pretty good, actually. You know, like, I was expecting it to be not good at all. Like, looking at it, I was like, that is a garbage controller. I was actually kind of surprised. I totally don't remember how to do this one. There we go. Do you like the Pro Controller? I really did want it, but you know, the Switch plus Zelda and everything was so expensive, I was like, I can really hold off on getting another controller. Oh man, all these weapons are so much better than what I have. I'm really fond of these. I know the spears tend to be a little bit lower in damage, but I'm really fond of them. Oops, oh, god damn it. I mean, it's crazy, man. All of the stuff is way too expensive. I mean, the Joy-Cons themselves, just the regular Joy-Cons, are like 80 bucks, right? I'll think about picking them up. Like I said, I was really quite surprised. I expected this to be a really uncomfortable controller. Maybe for some people, maybe if you had like significantly bigger hands, maybe it would be. I wouldn't say that I have like huge hands or anything though, so it's been quite comfortable for me. I'm trying to actually like dodge and stuff this time around. Could totally get rid of this guy. Oh, please. Oh man, it's so annoying. So are you going for the going for just like exploration? Have you actually been doing the Divine Beast and stuff? A friend of mine, he didn't do a single Divine Beast until he was probably like 50 hours in. And I just got all this food and I'm just like eating through it. Don't really want to use that yet. I don't have any just like straight up normal food though. Wish I had a bunch of durian. I should really head out there, because durian is like just so, it's so good. Okay. Alright, yeah, that works. So oh shit, I should have thought through that one. So which divine beast did you go for first? Out of curiosity. Hey, what's up, Elise? Yeah, you did miss a couple of parts. You can always rewatch them, though, bud. Plus, I'm still really early in the game, man. I wouldn't worry about it. How you doing, Elise? Hey, Batman, what's up, dude? Now you guys are rolling in. Ooh. Oh, it's one of these. I hate these. These are the ones... I'm so bad at this. Like, I actually might... I might have to go get Kayla for this part. I don't know what it is about, like, this particular thing, but I'm just really, really bad with it. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, we're gonna get one, please? Aw. Oh, there you go. Batman, I love your movies. I love how you always get comments like that, dude. Hey! It's a pretty odd time for me to be streaming, though, right? Not usually streaming, like, early. Not like this. Like, if I'm streaming early, it's usually like... Like, I started streaming at midnight, and I'm streaming until about, like, 3. It's not usually I'm getting up at 7 a.m. and streaming. I always love you. Trying to think, Gerudo. I can't even remember which one the Gerudo is. So like, I think I did the elephant. I did elephant first. And I've heard a lot of other people also say that they did the elephant first, Pyro. I was just interested if there were any other people that actually didn't do the elephant first. I don't remember which one the Garuda is. I'm guessing that maybe that's the desert area. I also don't want to spoil anything, so I'm like trying not to say anything. Yeah, we're actually going to, me and Kayla are going to like an art festival today, so that's why I'm streaming so early. I actually got some good sleep too, guys. I know, it's amazing. Okay, so you went towards the camel. See, that's interesting. That you were the first person that I've talked to that actually approached something other than the elephant first. And I was wondering if the game was sort of designed in a way that... Wait, how are we gonna do this? It was sort of designed in the way that, like, obviously it doesn't hold your hand and make you go a certain way, but if it was sort of just designed to make you, to guide you towards that particular one first. Come on. It reacts so slow. Waiting to the like for a time that I actually get to one that I haven't done before. It's like super hard. I'm just like, I don't have the time for this shit. It certainly seems like it pushes you that way. Yeah, I agree. The game, at least the game doesn't run. It used to have some frame rate issues. I think literally just like really, really recently they just fixed that. And by really recently, I mean like 3 days ago they just fixed it. But it was never bad. I mean, I think people made it out to be a little bit worse than it really was. There were a couple of frame dips here or there. I guess they were related to the Wi-Fi. It's funny, because a bunch of people were saying that, like, I guess RMX, is it RMX Racer? RX Racer? It's a racing game that was launched with the Switch, and a lot of people were saying that what was making that have performance issues was totally different from what was making Breath of the Wild have issues, and it turns out that they actually both were having issues from something very similar. Was it hard to stream on my stream? I don't know what you mean, man. Is it hard to stream on my stream? Oh, hi. Well, okay then. All right, I fucked that up, didn't I? Guess it's a good chance to get this chest right here. Oh, diamond, nice. Very nice. You know, the desert is the one area in my main file that I did not explore enough. I would like to go over there and explore it more. I don't know why, I guess I found it really annoying that you walked so slow in the desert, and then you have to worry about, like, all the heat stuff. Oh, was the Switch hard to stream? I wouldn't say it's hard to stream. I just got a capture card. That's pretty much, you know, the only way I can do it right now. The desert, it's cool. It's a really cool area. It's just such a pain in the ass to navigate, Pyro. But, Elise, I mean, I just used a capture card, man. Unfortunately, I got the Razor Ripsaw, which is, it's having freezing issues. I wish it wasn't, but that is the case. So, like, occasionally you guys might see it freeze on the screen for a second. It's super easy to fix on this end, but I'm probably going to need to return it, unfortunately. Hey. I'm usually a fan, though, Pyro, of, like, desert areas and snow areas. Like, those two things, usually, I'm a serious sucker for. I guess I just like extreme environments. Like, I also really like the area near the volcano as well. But it's such a pain in the ass to navigate, man. You walk so slow. Those seal things, those are pretty cool, though, right? Hey, it's a tower. Can't believe I haven't gotten this one yet. TJ, how did I already make you a mod over here, dude? I totally don't remember making you a mod. Is that what the crown is? I mean, obviously you're allowed to be a mod over here. Oh, you have Twitch Prime. Okay. That's interesting. I guess that means that, like, it's like ad-free for you or something? Yes, I am also on Twitch. I don't know. I had for a couple of days, Oh, see, look, it right there. It froze again, guys. That's what I was talking about. It's the second time it's happened already. I'm going to really have to address this. Luckily, it's not hard to fix. Yeah, I had left up on a couple of streams for a little while that I was using both Twitch and... Oh, shit. Oh, it's this place. This is so hard. I might... Oh, fuck. I might have to save scum this. I left it up for a couple of streams with text letting people know that I was now streaming to Twitch and YouTube. Wow, these things, there's just no way. Like, what the fuck am I supposed to do about this guy? If the dude wasn't stationary, I guess it'd be okay. Fuck that tower. I hate that tower so much. I took the text down. In fact, not only did I take the text down, I don't know if you guys noticed, but I usually have like the chat window, so normally you would be able to see that there are people talking in YouTube and Twitch. But I was having issues for some reason. I don't know why, but the capture card, when I extended it to the border of the chat window, it just didn't seem to want to work correctly. What the fuck? Dude, don't put me here. Come on. You've gotta be kidding me. Fuck this, I'm out. Goodbye. And yeah, Pyro, I agree, man. The seals are really cool. I think that they're sort of hard to control, honestly, because they're like they're very spazzy. You know, you turn one direction, you like sway all the way. But once you sort of get the hang of it, it's a lot of fun. Now, I think I'm ready now. When I started the stream, pretty much no one was in here. Today it took a little while to get people in here, but I decided that I was going to go back. I wasn't really prepared for this yet. Oh, hey, check that out. I think I'm ready now to make the trek up this mountain thingy. Oh, there we go. Oh, god damn it. Yeah, I'm actually doing the Zora thingy right now. Welcome, by the way. We don't need that one. I don't think. I don't remember which one was first. Whatever. They both serve their purpose, I suppose. Okay. I'm trying to find where the... There it is. Hey, there's another one right there. How did I miss that? Gonna mark it. It's kind of silly. Have I modded you over here, dude? I don't know if I've modded you over here. If I haven't modded you on Twitch, I apologize. I'm not very good at this. Hold on. Let's see if I can. Amber wanted me to do it too. Just give me a second here, guys. I'm sorry. There you go, bud. I don't know what you mean by you're saying scat. I would assume what you're trying to say is skate. I keep thinking you're talking about scat like the card game. Like, I really want to play scat, man, but you just won't wake up. He's probably tired, dude. You guys are doing like the sleepover thing. I'm sure you guys are up late. Hey, dude, you don't have to apologize, man. Not a reason to apologize. I used to love skating, and then I got old and, you know, my sense of mortality set in, and I realized I could die, so I stopped. Hey, it's one of these. These are like my favorite. I love these shrines. Sometimes the left Joy-Con doesn't respond the way that it should. It's only the left one. I don't know why. It's really annoying. See? Like, I'm doing like crazy shit right now. What are you doing? Here. Like, trying to move it. What are we gonna use here? I wouldn't say you're dumb at all of these. Giving you a hard time. Like. Yeah, man, like, I always hate it when people come in here and they apologize because they don't speak English very well and, because their native language isn't English. And I always hate that because, like, I'm like, dude, you really don't have to apologize for that. Like, I personally cannot fluently speak any other language. So, like, if you're in here and you're even trying to communicate with me and you don't natively speak English, you're doing a pretty damn good job, in my opinion. Batman's my hero, too. Wait, why did I do that? That's silly. I don't even need to do that. I want to get rid of one of these, like, crap shields. These Guardian shields. I don't know why. I just love this. I love the Guardian weapons. They look so cool. I believe there's a chest in here or something. Maybe there wasn't, I already grabbed it. No. I see what you're saying. It's all good, dude. Not everyone needs to be a fucking scholar. We're all just chilling. Not a grammar Nazi. What was that? I'm so not even paying attention here. I'm really not. See? As a bow. Good job, Steve. You win. Drop this. This garbage. But, you know, I do get a lot of people that apologize and say, hey, you know, I'm not a native speaker. Sorry. My English is bad. I'm like, dude, you don't have to apologize. You just did a lot better than I could. Whatever language you speak, you know? One more. Which, coincidentally, there's one right up this path, so this will be getting another heart. I think that generally, especially at a younger age, I think that females are better with English. I mean, certainly better with handwriting, right? I mean, my handwriting still looks like I'm 5-year-old, so. And I'm 30, man. I'm old. I still can't write for shit. Hey, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. Pretty good shot. Not bad. That was a horrible shot. On the right way here. Ah. What do we got? Let's see. Hey, cricket. I told myself that I wasn't going to be heading towards a divine beast like anytime soon. Yet here I am. Goodbye. Are you serious? So wait, your mom's handwriting was so bad that your teacher called to make sure that you weren't trying to fake calling out sick? That's hilarious. That's really funny. That's like, hold on to that nugget, because that's something that you hold on to for the rest of your life and constantly remind your mother of. Oh shit. I can't believe they haven't hit me yet. I think these guys look really, really cool. They're probably like the coolest looking race out of all of them. Hey, what's this? Traveler bow. I think all of the landscapes in this game look really, really nice in general. Oh. These rusty things are breaking all the time. I suppose they are half broken already. Hey, what's this stuff? I don't have any way to set this on fire. Oh, here we go. Of course it's raining. I like these weapons too. It's resting against this log here. I love the grass. Love how it gets cut when you're like swinging swords. Very nice touch. Huh. Eat your betrothal. Probably should grab this bow too. I have so many really, really bad bows. Sometimes, occasionally, the camera can be kind of disorienting in this game. Please don't go out, please don't go out, please don't go- Oh, god damn it. Fucking rain. It's always raining, you know, exactly when you need to do anything that involves climbing or fire. Damn you, weather. I saw someone talking about how they wish that they had implemented the Ocarina into this game. And then you could later control the weather and stuff. I think that would have been really cool. I would have been absolutely okay with that. I don't think it's probably gonna- I don't think it's gonna stop raining anytime soon. No, apparently it's not. We're saying freaking? Yeah, that's pretty lame. A lot of teachers are really, really old school. Kayla's a teacher. And all the kids love her a lot. So, because, like, the principal at their school is... She sort of like a private school that she works for, I guess you could say. And the teacher there, she's a lot older, or the principal. She's quite a bit older, so she's very set in her ways. And, oh, I'm not even gonna mess with this. I totally, like, lost where I'm supposed to go here. And anyway, so... She's, like, into yoga and being super healthy, and she thinks that, like, anything that has to do with screens is just the absolute devil, you know? So she's really against, like, kids watching TV, kids watching movies, any of that kind of stuff. She's just super, super against this kind of stuff, so... Obviously, Kayla dating somebody who's very into streaming and making content for YouTube and whatnot. She does not mind these things at all. And she's totally like the savior to all the kids at that school because she's really, really cool about that kind of stuff. She doesn't give the kids a really hard time. apparently there's some kid there that he says that when he grows up, he really, really wants to be a streamer. And the principal is like, you know, you should have a real dream. Caleb is like, you know, hey, if that's really what you want to do, that's what you should do. Yeah, everything in Nintendo. I could see that. I could see that. When I was younger, my mom really liked NES. And she's not really into gaming now, at all. In fact, I think she almost, like, hates video games now. I think they got a little bit too advanced for her. But she was always really cool. She could at least make the distinguish. I remember when I got a PS1, right? I really wanted a PS1. I think they got it probably for my birthday or something like that. And my mom was really trying to get me to get an N64. She wanted me to get an N64 so bad. And I was like, I don't want an N64. I want a PS1. I'm still happy with that decision today. I think that the PS4 had some, or the N64 definitely had its place. And there are a couple of really, really good games for it, but the PS1 had a lot of really great titles. I think it's shitty for anyone that's has your response, like it's, your future is their responsibility. I think it's really shitty for them to tell you what you can and what you can't do, you know, as an adult. That's not cool. You know, if it's your dream to do something, it should be supported, regardless. I mean, if you really wanted to be an astronaut, right? Say you're like, I really want to be an astronaut when I get older. I want to be a big politician when I get older. I think that a lot of teachers would totally be on board with that idea. They'd be like, yeah, you know, like, you absolutely should try to be an astronaut when you get older. You know, you're just going to have to study really hard. But if you want to be a content creator or anything like that, then they're gonna put you down, and it is difficult. It is really difficult to make a living off being a content creator. That's totally true. It's not something that's really easy to do, but so is being an astronaut. You know, like I would feel it's probably even more realistic to think that you're going to make a living someday being a content creator than an astronaut. Fuck these things, by the way. Fuck these things. I guess I'm just gonna have to use my bow on them. Oh, he helped you build your gaming PC? You have a really cool dad, then. I don't remember these guys giving me, like, this hard of a time my first time up this path. Just gotta stand up on the ledge and shoot down at them. I can't even remember where that was. I am a firm believer that whatever you want in life, it doesn't matter what it is. You know, whatever it is that you want in life, you should never believe that it's unattainable, ever. That once you stop believing that you can do something, that's probably going to be the case. I am so goddamn screwed. Come on. That self-defeating attitudes, you know, that leads to failure. No one else is gonna believe in you unless you believe in you. Yeah, man, I hate that stuff. I really, really hate it. I'll tell you what, like, if whatever kids get my girlfriend as a teacher, they're really, really lucky. They're really lucky. I am getting my ass kicked so hard by these guys right now. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna have to try to start doing. Welcome, by the way, AJ. Nobody should be shooting down kids' dreams. You know, that kids, younger people, it's so easy to leave an imprint on younger people and to influence their train of thought and stuff like that. Don't shoot them down. Let them know that there are a lot of possibilities in this world, and especially being young, that's the best time to start pursuing your dream, because if you really want something, and you want something for the rest of your life, you know, like, this isn't, like, you're gonna stick with this, even when you're older and you're adult, this is still your dream. Being young is the best time to start. That's the best time to start researching. Oh, thanks, man. That's the best time to start researching. That's the best time to start getting good at something. That's when you want to start getting good at something. And if... the sooner you start, the better. That's when you should be telling kids, this is the time, man. Pursue this. It gets a lot more difficult as you become an adult. I don't understand, like, why... I feel like the bow that I picked... I suppose it could be metal, but I'm not... Fuck you, dude! I'm getting so mad right now. I am 50% to redneck rage at this moment. This, you guys might start. If you're wearing headphones, turn them down. The problem is, like, I want to hit them from afar, like you said, AJ. But the problem is that sort of like where I'm encountering them. That's not making it easy. I suppose I could... Whoops, that was not a good idea. I suppose I could, like... That's wood, right? Let's go with that. He's jealous over your PC. See, I would think that if your dad's really into building PCs and stuff, he would probably have a really good one himself, right? Yeah, I think that's a fair assumption. Right. Fuck you, bat. I'm saving. I'm not even joking. I'll fucking save scum my way up this if I have to. If I'm gonna die, I might as well respawn or reload like right here. Oh, he plays the Xbox One? So he's not a PC gamer himself? Okay, so why is this working out so well for me now? You suck, bats. The electric bats, these things are legitimately probably my least favorite thing in the entire game. Definitely the most difficult to deal with out of all of them. Now that I get those first ones out of the way, though, I think this should be pretty easy. We'll get this one too. New file. Pretty broke. You know, that's... You should really, really respect your father for that, because that means that your father chose to give you a PC, a good PC, when he didn't have one. And that's really amazing that your father cares that much, because not everyone's that fortunate. Really cool. I'm glad you got an awesome dad. Am I like right back where I started, or is this? No, I don't think. Let's see. No, I think I'm going the right way here. Yeah, totally cool dad points. Hey guys, how's it going? I'm gonna take this off. I think when I was really young, I've told the story before in the stream, or at least on the channel, I'm sure, but when I was really, really young, I got a copy of PlayStation Magazine, and it was the Tomb Raider 2 edition. That's how old I am. Tomb Raider 2 edition of PlayStation Magazine. And I think that was the first time I was so blown away. Like, that was the first time that I really realized that, wow, adults make a career when playing video games. You know, like video game journalism is a thing. People make money off of this. It doesn't have to just be for kids. And that was like, that was a huge, huge realization for me. And I think I like the idea of, yeah, Tomb Raider's great. Even Tomb Raider 2 was a really great game for its time. But I think that was probably when I really realized that maybe deep down I wanted to pursue something with video games as I got older. And my parents shot that down really, really, really hard. They really did. They, even today, they don't agree with me, like, streaming and stuff. They think it's a total waste of time, which is unfortunate. So your dad, if your parents or your dad is, like, really supporting your hobby for gaming and stuff, that's really awesome. And I think it's a good time for that. I think that now, you know, I'm older now, so, like, I'm, like, 30. I think a lot of people are the millennials, I'll say, are having kids, and they grew up in video games. So I think that this generation, probably not everybody, but has it a lot easier in that sense. Come here, frog. Hey, you just disappeared. I'm totally, by the way, I should probably. What's my food situation like? Yeah, should be good. Let's save regardless. Game's pretty good with auto-saving, though. Hello. That's awesome. I'm really glad your parents support that. Really wish all parents would support that kind of stuff. Anything, really, like I said, you know, like, anything that is your dream, even if it's not a video game, if it's anything that is your dream, your parents should support what you want in life. Do I ever play Time Splitters? I played Time Splitters 2 a long time ago. I think they're making a new one. There's a team that's actually working on a new one. Yeah, I agree with AJ. Well, they grew up there was a huge stigma. When I was younger, there was a huge stigma against gaming. There really was. Like, when I was young and first really got into gaming was not something that you really walked around and talked about. It's not something that you admitted to people that you were, like, really into gaming. People would definitely, I'm sure to some extent there might be some stigma out there, but it was bad when I was young. It was really bad. It was something that you sort of kept hush-hush. I think that it was new. It was a new form of entertainment, and people just didn't understand it. And the way that I always looked at it was that, you know, I have a very short attention span, so I would rather be doing something that's interactive rather than sitting on my ass and watching TV. And even that goes for, like, watching streams, you know? Like, you guys are watching streams, but you're... Oh, there you go. But you guys are also being social. This, and it's funny because it's totally... Video games... Even today, I think, are somewhat looked at as a very unsocial thing, and that's completely not true. That is actually the complete opposite of what gaming is. Gaming is an extremely social hobby, much more so than a lot of other hobbies, because you're constantly interacting with people. And not only are you constantly interacting with people, but you're constantly interacting with people from all over the world. And that's really cool. That's really cool, really incredible. It provides a much more cultured mindset, and it allows people to be much more accepting of diversity. Like, it's a beautiful thing, and it is extremely social. If anyone ever tells you that gaming, you know, it's very antisocial, total bullshit. Obviously have no idea what they're talking about. And are probably from a generation, like you said, they grew up with different dreams. Oh, we are so much more connected. That's totally true. It's a really, really awesome thing. I brought this up in another stream recently too, but can you imagine, like, going back even 100 years, even 100 years from now, and be like, in the future, 100 years in the future, we are all going to be sitting around playing in a digital world, talking to people, potentially talking to hundreds of people around the world. You know, like, it instantaneous, just instantly responding to people that, you know, you're in the US, like in China, and people would be like, what? That's crazy. Like, what are you smoking, dude? Yeah, mind blown. I used to skate a lot when I was younger. I used to ramp skate quite a bit. Go down to the skate park all the time with my friends. Fuck this guy. This guy's an asshole. Shooting me with his lightning arrows. You will be dead in 100 years. I'm talking about if you had gone in the past. You might not be dead in 100 years. Who knows? Who knows? Wait. I decided I don't want this weapon. Can I not have this weapon? There we go. Ooh, it's a purpley. Let's just save scum. Ooh. Yeah, I don't want to live that long. I really don't. Oh man, the Switch is wonderful. It's a great console. I have absolutely no regrets. I'm not a huge, you know, before I go any more into this, I've said this many times too on my channel. I'm not a huge Nintendo fanboy. I'm not. There are a lot of things that I really don't like about Nintendo, specifically their business practices and their social views. I'm not very happy in that regard about Nintendo. It's been a long time since I was really into a Zelda game. The last Zelda game that I really enjoyed was Wind Waker. But the Switch is probably my favorite console in a very, very long time. And the reason for that is because it is its convenience. It is one of the most convenient consoles I've ever played. And this is something that seems sort of obvious, but I feel like you don't truly understand unless you have really had a lot of hands-on experience with the Switch. Yeah, the Switch was 100% a really great buy, and I honestly think, I predict really great things for the Switch. I think that it's going to do some really good things. Hey, Black Dragon, welcome back, dude. It's been a while. How you doing, man? I think you'll enjoy it quite a bit, at least. Fuck you, bird. I predict that they're going to become a little bit more affordable in the future. What I think is going to happen is I think... And they claim that this is not going to happen, and you can't blame them for claiming this is not going to happen, because it would be a poor business decision to outright say this.
Oh.
But I think that the 3DS is going to be very soon, probably by the end of the year, completely phased out, because this is clearly the right step for Nintendo to make. Like, they totally succeed in the handheld market, you know what I mean? But obviously it's very annoying to have to sit around and only play handheld. I don't think that they would survive very well just on that market and just on that idea alone. So I think that merging their home entertainment system and also making it handheld was the best business decision they could ever have made. And I think that that is going to really, really send them to completely new heights, because they're no longer competing with Microsoft. They're no longer competing with Sony. They totally have their own thing going for them right now, and it's something very unique and different. Hey, Jurgen, thank you, man. Appreciate it. I think my voice is pretty sexy. And I'm glad you're back, Black Dragon. It's been a while, man. Of course, I remember you, though. Oh, the moment, if you own a Nintendo Switch, you know that's a lie. Like, the first time that you get your hands and you play with a Nintendo Switch, you're like, oh, 3DS is fucked. There's no reason to keep it. Like, I picked up my 3DS the other day and, like, played Pokemon Moon, which is a great game. You know, Pokemon Moon is a really good game, but I played it for about 10 seconds, and owning the Switch, I was like, fuck this, totally not worth it. Dance like you've never danced before, Elise. I really love it when we get into deep conversations like this on my channel. That is honestly my favorite thing about streaming. Like, you know, like I enjoy playing video games, but I think the interaction is something that I love. And if I ever get a lot bigger to the point where my chat is just scrolling all the time, I'll get really sad because I really enjoy bouncing ideas off of you guys and talking about political issues, especially when they involve gaming and stuff. That's just one of my favorite things. I haven't seen Admiral in a long time, but Admiral actually stopping by before my break. So I looked recently, he's still subscribed, but he doesn't have an icon anymore and it's like grayed out, so I have no idea what's going on with him. Yeah, that's something I talk about this a lot with Kayla. If you guys are new to the channel, Kayla's my girlfriend and she sometimes streams with me and stuff. But, you know, like I was talking about this and she was like, well, you know, if you ever get a lot bigger, it's eventually going to be near impossible for you to communicate with people. And that's a really scary thought for me. I'm not sure I ever want to be that big. That would suck. I really, really love the social aspect of this. I love hearing what you guys have to say on serious topics and like I said, bouncing ideas off of you guys. It's what makes this so fun. I'm one of those streamers that honestly, possibly to a fault, I don't pay attention as much to the game as I should and end up dying quite a bit because I'm paying a lot more attention to you guys and what you guys have to say. Get out of here, Boomerang, come on. I love the color scheme. The color scheme in this game is so brilliant. Ooh, nice shots there. Where do I go? There we go. I also happen to have pretty much the best sub base ever. I've always said that. I'll continue to always say that. I love my subs so much. Just got a really, really great community. Yeah. And like I said, you know, it's not the fault of big streamers when they can't talk that much because it's hard, man. It's really, really hard when your chat bar is constantly scrolling. I feel like your brain is going to explode trying to follow that and playing games. I mean, it's hard enough just to talk and play in general. So I don't fault a lot of big streamers like that, but it's unfortunate that that is a thing. Yeah, what's up, man? Is this... I don't even know where I'm supposed to go, guys. Is it this way? This way? I'm trying to follow the road, right? Let's see what's going on over here. I remember Black Dragon. I think about that all the time, and that is possibly one of my fondest memories of a stream, was when it was like, it was like the afternoon, I was just waking up and we were watching like ancient Mickey Mouse cartoons and we were all just chilling out waiting for Deus Ex to install. I had a lot of fun with that stream. Yeah, I'm going to Zora's Domain. Yeah. Yeah, people have been rolling in. I don't know what bridge you're talking about. Oh, this bridge right here, right? Or did I just came up this bridge, didn't I? I think I went up this bridge. I think that's how I got here. Oh, I see, you're right. Yeah, I knew what you were saying. Popeye as well. Yeah, that's right. That was really, really fun. I'm sure at some point in the future I will totally plan to play like black and white cartoons, like ancient cartoons like that again. That was just a lot of fun. I could have totally had the stream, you know, 100% demonetized. I don't think I would for cartoons that are that old. Like those cartoons were ancient, but I'll totally take, you know, a hit on monetization just for something like that, because we had such a blast. Hey, you know, you gotta have a life, dude. Like I said, I'm really glad you stopped by. I actually end up missing a lot of my subs. Like if some of my subs don't show up for a while, I end up missing them. I'm being pretty stoked to see them return. Those are the days when I was doing a lot of Overwatch streams back then too, right? I don't play the competitive games as much anymore. Because it's hard to communicate with you guys while I'm playing a competitive game and really focus on the game. So I find that single-player experiences work out a little bit better for viewer interaction. Aw, thanks, man. I really take that to heart. Thank you. I work very, very hard on my channel. Oh, shit! No, don't wave to me. Don't wave to me. Oh, bad news. Yeah. Whew. I'm trying to understand what you were saying. Someone asked how to you Bedome a mod. How do you become a mod? Is that what you're asking? In this channel, there's a line. Like, you be a mod just by showing up a lot. If you show up a lot, you're here all the time, you know, you have a good attitude, you interact with people, you'll be in line for mod. It's really as simple as that. As of right this second, I'm not in need of a mod, because I have... You can't have too many, it's hard. I wish I could mod everybody, but, like, you have to... There's got to be a balance, because if people come in here and they're seeing just a wall of mods talking, it's kind of a turnoff, I think, for a lot of people. So, you know, it happens every so often. How often do I stream? Anyone that actually watches me a lot is going to totally laugh at what I'm about to say, but I try to keep a schedule. Recently, I've been trying to keep a schedule. So... I have really bad insomnia. It's hard for me to make a schedule and stay on it. And I hate saying that I'm going to do something and then not deliver for you guys, because that's not fair to you guys. But as of right now, what I attempt to do is that I try to stream Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And then lately I've started a new video series because people were requesting that I do videos. So I've started a new video series, and... That happens about once a week. I usually work on those videos about Monday and Tuesday, sometimes Wednesday if they're taking a really long time. I can always stream Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and it does happen occasionally, but I aim to always stream Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. I mean, not Monday, I'm sorry, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And my videos are very, very, very different from my streams. My streams are very chill. You know, I try not to like shriek a lot and be very loud. I try to just be me. and be real and hang out with you guys. And then my streams are very, my videos are very different. They're really goofy. They're very, very fast, or they're very heavily edited. They're mostly just for laughs. And lately I've been doing videos. I started a series called In Retrospect, which is, it's basically a video series covering games that were really, really important to my love for gaming and developing my love for gaming. So I'm doing a lot of older stuff. All right, see you later, Lise. Awesome, Black Dragon. I'm glad you guys stopped by. Take it easy. Hey, we're finally here, right? That took long enough. Current mods I do have right now have been following me for a very, very long time. Amber, who's in here quite often, and if you come here a lot, you'll see her. She's one of my mods. She's been following me pretty much since I really started to decide to take my channel seriously. Batman's been here for a really long time, too. I don't know when you joined, Batman. Do you remember what stream you started joining in on? I don't know what you mean, AJ. You'll have to elaborate. I'm really... Thank you, Elise. I take it to heart so much when people say they love my videos, because if you guys... It takes me like 10 hours to make one of those videos. The last one took me even longer, and I'm really proud of the last one. I think there's a couple of rough cuts because the game... I was playing a DOS game. It was giving me a lot of trouble. And then towards the end, man, I was so done with that game. I was like, no more. I'm so done here. But I had a lot of fun making the last one. I've been here like when it was just B and other good ones. I don't know what you mean, man. Arc streams. I think that's probably where my channel really started picking up, actually, was the Arc streams. Me and Kayla doing Arc. Those were a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. We got a lot of subs for those. A lot being relative, because obviously my channel's not huge. I haven't been seriously in the game for that long. Yeah. People came in and they were asking for videos a lot, and I was pretty much just streaming, and I've always wanted to do a lot of videos. And when I decided to start doing videos and start like a series and doing them a lot, I decided that I really wanted them to be different from my streams, because my streams have a very specific tone, and I thought that videos would be a really good chance to do something sort of really different. And something a little bit more fun and not as serious. And so far, they've been a blast. Like, I've really enjoyed making In Retrospect. I'm very fond of that series, and I think it's grown tremendously, I'm only 4 episodes in now? So, it's grown tremendously from episode 1 to episode 4. And it's also a really good chance to hone my skills, right? I've always wanted to do a lot of videos, and it's tough. Doing video editing, it's not easy. It's a lot easier to just sort of throw up a stream. Yeah, exactly. The aim was to give you guys some different flavors. See you later, Elise. Thanks for joining, bud. I'm sure I'll see you again soon. So Monday, so tomorrow. Tomorrow's Monday, so I'll probably start working on a new In Retrospect episode tomorrow. I think the next one is going to be the original Zelda. Since I've been doing a stream on the newest Zelda, I thought it'd be really fun to do the original Zelda for an In Retrospect. And that will be an especially interesting one because the original Zelda is my earliest memory. Huh. Watching my mother play the original Zelda, like that's probably my strongest earliest memory. Oh. been sleeping. I do too. I've always been super fond of Zelda, and like I said, I sort of fell in love with it after Wind Waker, which is too bad, because I've always loved the world of Zelda. Zelda itself has always really intrigued me. And then this one is so goddamn brilliant. Like, how could you not love this? I feel like pretty much a fan of any genre, you know, as long as you're not only into hardcore shooters. I think pretty much anybody could find this to be a really, really entertaining experience and really enjoy it. And in addition to that, I have to say that the Zelda community, like the people that love Zelda, have all been really awesome. I'm really enjoying streaming this game just because everyone that has come into my channel and has been like, I love Zelda, all of them have been nice. I haven't seen a single rude person in here that really loves Zelda. Loves Zelda, I should say. Not sure if I really want to engage in the first Divine Beast. I might do it. But like once I start actually engaging in a Divine Beast, I'm sort of obligated at that point to actually finish it. I've beaten them all before, so I would assume that this time around it's probably not going to be all that difficult for me to figure out. Nor was it at, you know, all that difficult even the first time around. Certainly a lot easier than, say, like, you know, Dungeons and Ocarina of Time or something like that. Ocarina of Time, man, when I played a lot of Ocarina of Time, I got to a point where I would always get to the second water temple, and, like, that was it. I was like, I'm done. I beat Ocarina of Time. As far as I was concerned, once I got to the second water temple, I had beaten Ocarina of Time. Because it was just such a pain in the ass. You had to, like, take off the boots, put on the boots. Can't remember, there was another aspect. I think raising the water levels and stuff like that. Oh, man, that was just probably the most annoying dungeon of all time. I think that's probably correct, AJ. I would agree with that statement. I think that's... Ocarina of Time is a classic, right? That was the first one that was just monumentally successful. I have to say, me personally, this is my favorite Zelda. Probably my second favorite would be Ocarina of Time, would be Wind Waker, and then Ocarina of Time. I never played Majora's Mask. It's funny because, I keep saying it's funny, but it is because... Majora's Mask, when it came out, was really controversial. People did not seem to like it that much when it first came out, and it's fun. It's cool to see that in the future, like now, looking back, people seem to be very fond of Majora's Mask. But that really wasn't the case when it came out. Shock arrows. So when I first got here, there's the part where he asks you to go up and you have to find some shock arrows. And there's a part where there's a Lynel. I think I'm pronouncing that correctly. If I'm not, I apologize. But there's one up there, and I thought that you had to kill this guy. I didn't think that was optional at all. And I got my ass kicked by this dude so bad. And I think it took me like 2 hours to beat him, seriously. Then, you know, found out later, oh wait, you didn't actually have to beat him. That was completely optional. I think that's totally true. Hey, what's up, Corey? How's it going, dude? didn't know if you were up earlier when I had messaged you, so I just sort of like was like, meh. Wait to see if he gets up later. How are you doing, man? Ocarina of Time was... I mean, not Ocarina of Time. Majora's Mask was timed, wasn't it? Like, wasn't that a timed game? I think people were not very fond of that idea, and I think you're right, they did want another Ocarina of Time. Hold on, I'm gonna mod you, Corey. It's the second one, DJ. Give me a minute here, guys. Sorry. Bring up this one so I can see what you're saying. Yeah, I knew there was a way to manipulate that. Was it 3 days? And that's why I never played it, because I'm not a fan of games that time me to do things in general. You're proud of that E? I don't know what you're talking about, dude. Oh, I'm proud of that E in your name. God forbid someone doesn't include an E in your name.
Say my name.
Yeah, that's how old I am, right there. I wish this old dude would stop yapping. Yeah, exactly, and that is... I think that was a risky decision. Or maybe not, because, you know, like I was saying, people are now look back at Majora's Mask very fondly. So I guess I'm wrong, but I think that going from Ocarina of Time, which at its time was offered a lot of freedom, you know what I mean? Like, that was about as open world as games got for the most part back then. So I think that going from that and then adding a time constraint, I think that was a huge turnoff to a lot of people. And me personally, that's the reason why I didn't pick it up. It could be a brilliant game for all I know, and maybe if they re-release it for Switch, maybe I'll pick it up, and maybe I'll do like a Let's Play on it or something like that. Or a stream, we'll see. I don't ever really just do straight up Let's Plays, so it'll probably be a stream. Yeah, now there's a temple, something here, somewhere. Or is it? And the freedom in this one is just off the charts, right? It's on the 3DS, interesting. I won't pick it up because ever since I got a Switch, my 3DS might as well not exist. It just the screen quality is shit in my opinion compared to the 3DS and I mean to the Switch, and obviously the Switch is on a whole new level graphically speaking. You know, Corey, it's funny because we played last season, right? And I don't want this sledgehammer, they're too slow. I totally did not transfer my loot at all. I didn't. I just never went back to it. Never cared to go back to it. I just, you know, like anything that was on my character, obviously, I still have. But everything that was in my stash and stuff like that, I just said, fuck it. I don't even care. I mostly play season anyway, so it wasn't a huge loss for me. I'll probably still pick it up. I'll probably join you at some point for the season. I'm going out to an art festival a little bit later. So I'm not gonna be able to start probably till like later tonight, but I would definitely let me know, man, if you want to play later or something, and if I'm around, I'll give it a go with you. Oh, I hate this one. This one's like the worst. The level of the time that was put into this game. Does anyone know how long it took to develop this game? Because it must have been in development forever. There was so much thought put into this game. It is incredible how much thought was put into this game. I don't think I've ever seen a game that had this much time put into it, or this much effort put into it. They obviously had a lot of, you know, brainstorm sessions where they sat around and really thought through how they wanted to do this. And trying and how they wanted or how they were going to give the players as much freedom as they could possibly give them. I don't remember how I did this, you know, and Kayla recently did this one. Okay, so it's all the way up there. Only 5 years. That's incredible. When you think about it, also took 5 years to make Andromeda. Like, that really kind of puts things into perspective. Oh, that's right. There's actually a super easy way of doing this. I did this a really hard way the first time, and then I realized that there was a really, really easy way to do this. Here we go. Now, question is, let's see if we can go this way. Hey, what's up, Amber? How's it going? I've got like my wall of mods in Twitch. How the hell did I do this before? Oh, not like that. Not like that. Your back is killing you. That sucks. My back's always killing me. I have such a bad back. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Why? I might have to go get Caleb and be like, hey, how did you do this again? If you guys didn't know, over on Twitch, Dr. Landmine is Corey. That's the guy that I stream with sometimes. Well, I had a hammer, and then I dropped it, but I don't see how that's gonna help me if I can't make it up here. So, I guess I can try this. Being at an angle, I'm not sure how well that's gonna work out. Oh, okay. Dude, I'll tell you what though. Recently, here we go. This should work out a little bit better. I'll tell you what, man. Recently, my knees have been hurting so bad. I think that's because I'm a twitchy motherfucker. So, I'm always like nervously shaking my leg. Always. I think I've totally worn away at the cartilage in my leg because it's not been doing good in recent days.
Hey.
God damn it, of course. All right, let's... Maybe a little bit more gentle. Do I live by the ocean? Yeah, I live in Florida. And I grew up in Maine, so... Yes and yes. Dude, yeah, me too, man. Like, seriously, especially, I don't know about you, but if I'm having trouble sleeping, when I'm, like, laying in bed, I'm constantly shaking my leg. It drives Kayla crazy. She's like, can you please not shake your leg constantly? I'm like, no, actually, I wish I could, but I really can't. This is just kind of what I need to do. Oof. God damn you. Move. No, wait. No, not that way. No, not that way either. Oh, man. God damn it. That could be. That could totally be. What am I missing here? Why am I doing this so wrong? Like I said, when Kayla was doing this recently, I literally just said, like, three things. I was like, do this, this, this. And she just instantly did it. Also, I like how it just disappeared. Oh, here we go. It's going. They should have made a pinball puzzle. I think that would have been really cool. Yeah, man. Like, I'm just always doing it. I think like Corey said, you can't... I suppose you didn't see what he said because it's nowhere on Twitch, but... I think he hit the nail on the head when he said that. It's really an ADD thing. You know, I don't think they understand. I have a hard time... Please don't. Please... actually, you know what? I probably would have preferred that to fall because... She's better about it now. She is. Man. I think she's starting to get it, so she's like, okay, he really can't help this. Hey, what's up, Half-Heart? I did only hit it once, and it didn't even move. I'm thinking that maybe a less hard-hitting weapon might make a difference. Or like something I can control a little bit more, like a spear. Oh, my fucking... You guys see this, This never used to happen, and people have complained about this a lot, but my left Joy-Con really just does not seem to want to cooperate, for the most part. Can I just, like, move it? Move. I almost had it that one time. Let's see what I have for other weapons. We'll try this guy. I do not have a leaf on me. I never have a leaf on me when I need a leaf on me. Like, ever. Darksiders 2. I've never played Darksiders 2, but, dude, you're the second person. Nick also said that Darksiders 2 is fucking amazing, and I should pick it up. There we go. I can write it down. Are you talking about this ramp that I'm looking at right now? That's what I'm trying to do. I think you can. There's probably a way to do it this way, but this way's a lot easier. Line up your hips where you want it to fall. Hello, Jennifer. That could be it. That could help. It's all in the hips, guys. It's all in the hips. I want to do this, like, very carefully, because if this fails, I'll be sad. Please don't roll off, dude. Please don't roll off. Actually, you know what? I can save, in case it gets wacky from here. That way you guys don't have to keep watching me. So, now obviously I'm gonna need it to be like somewhat away from the wall, or this is not gonna work. It's like Zelda with way more violence, that might be up my alley. Now I want to try Darksiders 2. Of all the times that Nick tried to get me to play it, if he had just used those words, I would have been like, sold. I use OBS Studio. It's free. It's a little bit on the more, it's a little on the complicated side. It really is. Whoa, yeah, no. It's a little bit on the complicated side, but if once you figure it out, it's not so bad. It's quite good, actually. I enjoy it a lot. And it looks good. I'm using a capture card to be able to stream to Twitch. Switch on Twitch. Hey, look at that. I am sort of having some issues though where OBS, basically my capture card is freezing. Yeah, just lightly push it. My capture card is freezing every so often. I think it's happened once at least in this stream, and it's not hard to fix. I don't know who's ended on. At first I thought it was a capture card. I'm starting to think it's actually more on OBS's end, because it's very easy to fix by just deactivating and then reactivating it again. That doesn't seem like a hardware issue. I feel like if it was hardware, on the hardware end, and Corey can correct me if I'm wrong, and he probably will, but on the hardware end, I think that I would probably have to just completely restart the hardware if it was, like, locking up. Finally! I'm so sorry about that, guys. I lost, like, a bunch of viewers. My bad. I promise I'm not usually that bad at these. There we go. The capture card looks great, though. It has really, really good quality. Damn well have better, because it was really expensive. Hey, I can have another heart now. It's always the first, you know, it's funny because I actually say that to Kayla all the time. Like, if something is not working, she's not very tech savvy. God bless her. She's really not. And sometimes she's just like, this just won't work. And it's like the simplest thing in the world. And I was like, did you try turning it off and on again? And I say it with like a grin because she knows where that's coming from. Yet every time she still fails every time to follow that process because it really does work. It's a joke, but it's not a joke. Hey, Sans, what's up, man? Welcome back, bud. Yeah, it's funny because it is true. So, I don't know if it's a OBS problem. If it is, I could always attempt to try, like, changing over to XSplit. XSplit's another really popular one that I haven't used. Have you tried smashing it with your hammer? I don't think that generally fixes things. Oh god, this is gonna be another scene where somebody wants to bang Link.
I was thinking.
Quite the ladies, man. It was really funny in my last stream. I was like, why does every chick in all of the Zelda universe really want to bang Link? And then somebody replied, have you seen the other dudes in the Zelda universe? And I was like, touche. That was the greatest response that you ever could have had to that.
It's funny how, being a Hylian, you looked grown up so much faster than I did.
Mutsu is a jerk.
I was
just let us save your kingdom. It's not like we have any
even
other options.
Then.
Yeah.
So if this calamity Ganon does,
I wonder if anybody sells
time,
Link's shirt.
What can we really do?
I would really like that shirt. I'm not joking. I would buy the shit out of that shirt. Especially because I have blue eyes. So
that no matter how difficult
go well with them.
I'll
take buttons instead of laces, personally.
No matter when or how bad the wound.
Does it got like little buttons right there? Like where the laces are? Oh man, I would totally buy that shirt. I would pay
this whole thing
I'd pay
over.
Big bucks to own that
Maybe
shirt.
Things can go back to how they used to be when we were young.
I'm looking into you it. Know. I'm not even joking. After the stream, that's like the first thing I'm gonna look up.
Perhaps we could spend some time together.
I'll have to pull out a cam for that stream. I'll have to pull the cam out, which I don't do often. Just to show it off. I always get like super hungry halfway through my streams. You'd think that I would learn and I'd wake up and then I would eat something and then I would stream. Never do. This guy is an asshole. He's probably the biggest asshole in the entire game. Well, other than Ganon, obviously. Okay, so the last time I played this game, this guy's gonna tell me how to get some shock arrows and stuff like that, and he's gonna want me to go up the waterfall, and then there's a Lynel up there, right? Lynel's gonna kick my ass. It took me like 2 hours to kill him the first time around. You think he's more of an asshole than Ganon? I don't eat. Yeah. I don't eat. I don't sleep. I don't eat enough. It's true. But I've heard that this, all that whole step is completely optional, and that I don't have to do that. So, where am I, anyone got any suggestions? Where am I going to get shock arrows then? I don't even remember what town sells the shock arrows, and I most definitely have not unlocked that town yet. But what do they want? What do they want from me again? What do you want? Should I just go up there and try to, like, sneak around him and grab some shock arrows? Like, go ahead and show me the armor. Okay, so he wants me to equip the armor. I think this armor looks really cool, actually. I wish it was a little bit stronger. Hey, look, it fits me. I told you she wanted to sleep with me.
Huh?
Silly Muzu just not listening. Yeah, that's to prevent people, obviously, from posting malicious links. I don't want people posting malicious links in the chat. If you tell me where to go, though, I'll go check it out. You don't know anything about Zelda? Well, watch and learn. Did you miss the other streams, Amber? The other two streams? All right, can we get off the whole fact that she likes Link? Can we get over this now, please?
Ah.
Guy's very, very stubborn. You were here for the late night one, okay. Hey, welcome, Vladimir. It's .ca. SpiritShirt.ca. I'm sure if I really looked for it, I'd probably just do a Google search and find it fairly easily. Yes, tell me where to collect shock arrows. Come on, old dude. Amazon is definitely a possibility, yeah. I'm buying it. Not even joking. I'm serious. I'm getting that shirt. You guys will see it soon. I'll pull out the cam for a stream soon here. Once I get that shirt. Be the coolest fucking streamer on the block. 1 million subs. Probably the only streamer on my block. I'm on it. I'll do it. I think the ability that you get with this armor is really cool. What do you guys got? Anything interesting? Probably make some food. Man, these are so cheap. I'm gonna make a couple of quick dishes before I actually do make my way up there. Oh, I didn't want that much. Who cares? The music when you're making something, like making food, is so satisfying. I wish. I talk about durian all the time. Durian is absolutely the best. That's like, once I get to that point, I just farm it. Because I'm pretty sure this guy is just going to one-shot me. If I even try to fight that guy. Honestly, just one. Like, if you make... Oh, wow. If you make just one durian, it will give you full recovery. It will give you full recovery and... And I think 4 bonus hearts, if I remember correctly. Yeah. Yeah, that's true. I like how they censor, like they add pixelation over the really bad food. I always thought that was really funny. Like I said, I'm pretty sure that if I try to, I'll try to fight the Lynel, just for laughs, but I'm pretty sure that he's just going to one-shot me. Oh, we don't want to eat raw fish. Get some what? Get some durian? Hey, put these together. I'm scared to fight this guy. True story, Kayla actually stopped playing Zelda because she got to this part and she thought the dude was like way, way too hard. So I told her, because I'm an asshole, and really because I didn't know, that you needed to beat him to progress. And so she stopped playing. And then a good friend of mine later told me, no, dude, that's completely optional. You don't have to do that. I was like, Kayla, sorry, but I was wrong. You don't have to kill him. She's like, really? Really? What is this? Is this like one of the... Your dodge right? See, I was doing... The way that I killed him was I was doing the backflip dodge. And I would just flurry attack him over and over again. And it took me a really long time, actually, to get it down. I mean, I pretty much had to... I had to eat a lot of the food to make it work. I pretty much just healed my whole way through it. Because especially at the end, he starts, like, charging around and doing all this crazy stuff. I think I had actually sort of just hugged a rock and walked circles around it. Yeah! I saw the ability to do it. I never pulled it off because I suck. Is it really effective to do that? Does that do a lot of damage or something? Side dodge when he's running at me? I thought I had tried that and it didn't work out too well. Try it again. What does this do? Stamina. I don't really need stamina. Put some of these guys in. Oh, it's a speed dish. Whatever, just throw food. Food. No, but it's safe. Okay. And one more. I'm not going to make you guys sit here and watch me do this for 20 minutes. We'll just have to hope that this is enough food. Actually, I'm pretty much out anyway, aren't I? I did save that shock elixir. I think he does shock damage. We'll get some Hyrule herb. Hyrule herb is the dankest herb. Yeah, I mean, flurry attacks do that too, though, right? Let's do it. Gonna find this, there's like a waterfall. This guy's funny. Poor Sagan. Carl Sagan. It's gonna cut me down? Dude, you can't even pick up that arrow. Bring it. It's hard, man. It's quite hard, actually, to time them. Especially with the Switch's analog sticks. They're not the greatest analog sticks, unfortunately. They are incredibly sensitive. It's so easy to accidentally crouch, to accidentally bring up your Sheikah Slate. Your ancient iPhone. Hey, what's up, Chase? Yeah, I was mentioning that earlier, that this was a pretty early stream for me. But I'm gonna be gone later, so I figured earlier was better than no stream. But good morning. This is so much fun. I love this. It really never gets old. Oh no. Oh, I fucked up. I fucked up. I fucked up. Oh no, I'm gonna drown. Don't drown. So, oh, headshots from above, so like fly up and then freeze in the air and shoot him, is that what you're saying? That could work, for sure. Aha, here we are. I'm gonna try. I'll try doing it, just for fun. I don't think it's gonna go well, and if it doesn't go well, I'm just gonna take Jennifer's idea and just kind of sneak around. Drowned. Ooh, herb. Dank herbs. Oh, I don't need that either. Yeah, exactly. I'll give it a go. We'll see what happens. There's no harm in that. I'll give it a couple tries. I'm sure I'll die instantly the first time. Broadsword. I want that. Oh, I want that so bad. Ooh. Hello. They're like, yeah, you're gonna die. You might want some weapons. Come on. Come on, broadsword. Come to me. What is this? Knight's broadsword. I think the other one was a soldier's broadsword. We'll keep what I got. Look at me, already getting my ass kicked. This way. God, I love this game. I really do. Most fun I've had with the game in a very, very long time. I actually enjoyed Final Fantasy 15 quite a bit. Also, I didn't like it nearly as much as this, but I did put a lot of time into it, and I really enjoyed my time with it. Combat system was just so good in that game. Nice, man. How did that go? Okay, there he is. There's the bastard. They look so cool, though. They really do. There's one in the, in like a snowy area. Up by one of the mazes. He's really, that one's super tough. It's like a truck. Oh, good for you, man. I'm glad it went well. I was talking earlier about how my next In Retrospect episode was going to be on the original Zelda. So that's going to be coming up soon. Wow, this guy already saw me. Yeah, no. Fuck you, dude. Yeah, this is going to go great. No problem. I wonder if they intend for you to actually fight this guy, or if they're actually saying, hey, you should really sneak around this dude. Might have helped also if I had passed in my orbs for another heart up there. Oh, no. Hi. Fuck you. I'm doing this. Oh, that's right. You gotta dodge multiple times. He ran into me and killed me. He just walked into me and I died. They're all automatic two-hit KOs? Is that true? So, like, no matter how many hearts that you have, no matter how many hearts you have, it will always be a two-hit KO. Yeah, this is gonna go well. There we go. I wouldn't know, I really wouldn't. Fuck you! Alright, we got... It certainly... I gotta say, AJ, it might not be true, but it certainly seems that way. As everyone has always been too bits to kill me. This is the part that gets me. I don't understand how I'm supposed to, avoid when he's running around like that. Like, you say sidestep, it almost never seems to work for me. Look at how little damage I do this guy, it's insane. This is death right here, I'm gonna die. Oh, I was gonna try to mount him. Can I mount him? No? Dead. Oh, I actually got him that time. I mean, I guess I'm just gonna have to literally heal every time he hits me. Which I don't even think I have enough food for, honestly. Hearts and determination, guys. So cool at times. Grab my good food. Ah, damn. Okay, that's good to know. Yeah, see, I just tried to sidestep right there. I don't know, maybe I'm doing it wrong. Sidestep does not seem to work for me. I've never really liked the sidestep technique. Did I hit the shield there? It certainly seemed that way. Oh, very nice. Awesome. Awesome. Starting to get the hang of it. Yeah, unfortunately I didn't grab the freeze arrows. I wish I had known that, because that would help me a lot. And it's sort of a little late for that, I think. I'm actually dodging now. I should say I'm doing a lot better than I thought I would do, for sure. Come on, dude, please stop running around. I hate him so much. It's just when he runs around. That is that's by far the most difficult part, in my opinion. Actually, let's eat this stuff. It is sometimes. Not when he's running at me. Like that. And that's why I think when I actually beat him the first time, what I had to do when he was doing this was I basically just had to run circles around a rock and hope he would stop. Because... especially that one right there. Come on. Oh. Guys, I'm literally sweating right now. I'm totally running out of food too, so this is not going too well. Let's see, what do I got? That was very poorly timed. I'm gonna try what you had said and suggested. Oh! Now, I'm pretty sure if I have any hearts missing whatsoever, if he hits me again, I'm dead. Actually not doing nearly as bad as I thought I would do. I thought this would be really, really grim. Hey, stop running after me. Can you please just stop moving? Totally just hitting a shield right now, aren't I? Well, that's nice. Come on. We're close, guys. We're very close. Oh, fuck you. Come on. This is intense, guys. Did I get him? Hey, I gotta say, guys, I'm kind of proud of myself there. Like, I was totally saying that I was gonna not be able to do this. That wasn't so bad at all. Shield, bow. I don't know how good this bow is. But it's certainly better than my 5 damage bow, so. Ooh. Oh, you know what? I actually really hate the bows that shoot multiple arrows. I just eat through the arrows like way too quickly. Aw, oh, thanks. You can call me Steve, by the way. Steve's the name. Hey, arrows. Take all these shock arrows. I'll tell you what though, like I said, my very first time fighting him did not go nearly that well. I think it took me about 2 hours to beat him or so. Hour and a half maybe? I kept trying and trying and trying, and I mean I was so bad at dodging at the time. Missing arrows? I know there is a lot up here. There's quite a few arrows up here. There you go. Yeah, I don't like it when, I mean, I don't want to say I don't like it when people call me Glory to Gaming here. Obviously, you know, it's completely understandable. It's the name of my channel, but prefer my viewers just to call me by my name. Hey, shock arrow. Another one? Yeah, more cooking for sure. That's... cooking's on the menu. As ate through almost all my food there. In fact, I actually don't think I even have a whole lot of food to cook now, unfortunately. Yeah. And they're really like everywhere. Yeah, I should do that. Not paying enough attention to it. I know, because then it turns red, and then it probably even regenerates slower. The arrow's up there, too. You know, I could sit around and... like a bazillion of these, but not really sure I'm gonna need them. I felt that unfortunately, for the most part, all of the bosses within the Divine Beasts were very, very simple. I didn't find them hard at all. Even Ganon was a bit of a letdown. Oh yeah? How do you do that? Oh, that's really cool. Shoot and start. That's interesting. I didn't know that. Jump at your own risk. Hey! Another one of these. How many did I get? 25? Oh, so you haven't tried it yourself, you're saying it might work. Gotcha. Ooh, eating up my stamina pretty hard. That's so much fun. We got stamina food. Oh, wow. Even on my main account, my stamina's not that high. Ouch. Hey, do you like me now? Look at it, I got some arrows. Yeah, I killed him. I did that, dude. How about you? Oh, this is a lady fishy. Gonna be honest, lady fishy, you don't look a whole lot different from male fishies. Right? Who needs cars? Sprint forever.
Ah!
All I gotta do is whistle, and then I can just keep running. Wait. No. No! Wait, why is it telling me to go back up there? Okay, where is that? Alright, we'll try that. We'll go there. probably what I should have done. I don't think that I'm going to be able to, like... Should I load and then just go there instead? I'm guessing it's up. Or I suppose I could take the waterfall. God damn it. Fuck all y'all. Of course it's like raining constantly. I don't really have a preference, Sans. I'm kind of more of a PC guy, so I think that's what I'm gonna do, guys. I'm just gonna load and then float down. I think. Yeah, I don't really have a preference. I'm kind of a PC guy. I mean, if I had to pick and I didn't have a PC, I would personally probably pick Xbox just because I like a lot of, you know, PC-like games. If you do have a PC, yeah, PC Master is. If you do have a PC, though, already, and you play your PC, then there's not really much of a point to have an Xbox, because almost everything on Xbox comes on PC. So then in that case, I would suggest getting a PlayStation. But it's really a preference thing. I don't believe that there's one that's better than the other. Whatever you like gaming on. Probably, honestly, wherever your friends are. You know, if you have the most friends on one platform, it's probably the best platform for you. I will say that PlayStation also does have a lot of really interesting exclusives. Ah, here he is. Yeah, I found it. Like you said, I should have cooked up some more food. Not entirely sure that I'm gonna have another chance to do that. Although I might be able to sort of skedaddle out of there and then come back if need be. I don't know what you mean. I think I'm pretty okay with the glider. I really am like hella low on meals here. I guess I'll use this. Now, a friend of mine said that you can can actually destroy the ice blocks that get thrown at you with your power. I just used regular arrows my first time. Suppose I could try it his way. I really like this part. I like all of these parts, like right before you enter the Divine Beasts. Oh, he believes in me. Not someone does. I really like this as much. Oh, okay. Not so bad, actually. Pretty good. A lot better than, like, wasting all my arrows. I wish there was a lot more stuff like this. Ooh, those are fast, huh?
Here you go.
Hey, what's up? Welcome back, Derek. How you doing?
Shock arrow spray.
Yeah. Is this the last one? That's good to hear. Let's find another one. A lot better than not doing it. Guy just hit. Come on.
We're getting closer.
Look at me in the right one. That's not at all the right one, dude. Close enough, I suppose. So I guess we're gonna be doing this stream. That's a really interesting looking icon. What is that of? Kinda hard to see from here.
Well, Link, here we are. Looks like this is where the real work starts. Best of luck. Nice job cutting off the water flow from this divine beast. Show the enemy no fear. I'll see you back at Zora's domain.
All right, dude. Great shot.
Finish the job.
Hey, see you later, Jennifer. Thanks for stopping by. This is one of the divine beasts, if that's what you were saying. Done this one before, so hopefully it will be a little bit more on the snappier side. I do have to, gotta do this art walk thing with my girlfriend, so some point here, hopefully right after this, probably be shooting out of here. Then possibly a stream later. I know that Corey said that he was interested in trying out the new season of Diablo 3, so that might happen. Not really sure yet.
Ruta can be freed of Ganon's control. You'll need a map to prevent you from getting lost.
It's actually quite hard to get lost in these. They're not very big. In some of the later ones, I found it to be quite easy. I actually thought my first playthrough, I thought that this one was the harder one of the four. Yeah, I didn't really struggle with anyone. Again, this one I thought I struggled a little bit more with. Yeah, well, yeah, I don't get out of the house enough, man. Honestly, I really don't. Halos can be. I'm always in here working on my channel. So, you know, my girlfriend is, she's so supportive of my channel. She's like my biggest fan. She's crazy supportive, so it's really nice for me to once in a while go out and do what she wants to do, you know? And I guess we're gonna go meet up with some friends. Well, that should be fun. But I personally found this boss to be the hardest, and I don't know if that's actually because this boss is the hardest, or if it's actually just because, you know, I had the least amount of experience with this one out of all of them. It's moving. We're gonna do this one. You are... You're not moving, dude. You know what? Let's do it this way. It should be fun. I have a hard time, though, because, like, I care so much about my channel that I'm always, like, constantly thinking about it, so it's sort of hard for me to actually, like, walk away from it. Spend a day doing something else.
There are four terminals remaining. Don't...
Good for you to get some fresh air, though. And I don't know why... Come on. I have to lower the water or something. Yeah, it's true. And I mean, it's a lot of hard work, and you don't... The truth is that you don't make it unless you try really hard. I think a lot of people give up way too easily. It's a tough game. This is the hardest game to play, getting in the YouTube game. Pretty happy with my progress lately, though. More importantly, I'm really lucky to get, like, to get good subs. Everyone is usually really polite, really cool. I came from this way. Ah, yes, this part. See, this is the part where I struggled the most, and this is the part that I remember to why I thought that this one was so difficult the first time around. Yeah, it's true. It is, though. To be fair, it has been a lot of work. It really has been. But I do enjoy it a lot. I do have a lot of fun with it, definitely. That was not the right time to do that at all. Means I'm gonna have to wait for another rotation, I believe. Try this again. Here we go. Am I right? Hey, it's two down already.
There are three terminals remaining. You can do it.
Sweet. Question is, how do I get back out? Alright, so... Got that. We've got two down. Was there five? I think there's five. Each one, if I'm correct. Let's see. Can I not control him yet? It's damaged. I still have to go to the main terminal to get the map. I thought I did that, didn't I? And it said that I had to return later. I would assume you're talking about the big one. It certainly looked very main terminal. Is this what you're talking about right here? We tried that. Said no. Could be this one. We'll find out. Not a big deal. Which divine beast is this? This is the Ruta. This is the elephant. First one. Well, at least the first one I'm doing, I suppose. I could do it in any order, right? Welcome, Zillion. Zillion? Mate, did I get that right? Hey, there we go. That's the one. So,
good. You've obtained the map of the Divine Beast. You will see several glowing points on your map, which represent the terminals that control Ruta. Take Ruta back by activating all of the terminals.
I like her voice actor. I do.
Be careful.
I feel like sometimes some of the voice actors really kind of overact, at least the English voice actors in this game. I especially really like Zelda's voice actor. I saw IGN was ripping on her and saying that, so basically it was an article that, or video article, seven things that they like and seven things that they hate about Breath of the Wild, and one of them was they said that I don't think he outright said Zelda was a terrible voice actor. He just said he didn't feel that she was sounded part of the world. And I think that that's very inaccurate. I think that Zelda's voice actor was very good, personally speaking. Yeah, I mean, for the most part, I remember this stuff. Hasn't been that long yet. Really, I actually didn't know that. Wait. You know what though? I can freeze it. That's what I'm gonna do. It could be. She's really good. I think she did a really great job. IGN's always pulling shit like that, though. I don't know. Bums me out. Hey, Radlock, give me a second here, but I know you're saying something. Yeah? Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. How? I feel like I've got the right idea here. Not doing the greatest job at executing it. Maybe if I jump down. That's a really risky move, though. Steve, you failed. You fail me. God damn it. Bring me back over here. Don't make me go back all the way again. God damn you. Hey, welcome everybody. Is it really that rare? Is it rare for Breath of the Wild to be in English? I thought he was pretty good too. I personally, the king, in reference to King, I think though that really, I think that Zelda was my favorite. I'm sorry, AJ. What were you saying, bud? Yeah, it is a big step. There was a lot of really big changes in this one, and I think that for the most part they were all really for the better. I do miss the. The actual temples, though, and I suppose these are sort of take the place of the temple. But I miss the old school way of doing that. Wow, that's crazy. I didn't know that. I've just started streaming to Twitch, so this is my third Twitch stream. So I don't see a lot of Twitch streams. Generally speaking, I'm a YouTube channel. So I don't see a lot of them. I have noticed a few, though. There was, when I played Paragon, I noticed there was a lot of Russian people playing Paragon for some reason. So what the hell am I missing here, guys? Oh, I guess I could have done that right there, right? That would have been a really good time for that. This was the part that I was remembering that really I struggled with. God, fuck. Oh, thank you, Nathan. That's not a bad idea, man. It's more fun watching me figure it out. That's sadistic. You guys are sadistic. Nah, I think, oh, hello. What was that? Ooh, that was something. One more. Hey. Your first monk? Are you talking about the, You're talking about the ninja dudes? Nathan, you're getting shit. Twitch is giving you shit, buddy. Yeah, they are kind of creepy.
There are two terminals remaining. You're nearly there.
Thank you, Nathan. You know what? Screw those Twitch guys. I appreciate it. How many's left? What is it, two? We got two left, guys? I think that this one... So... Okay, I think I get how I'm gonna make this work. And they need to eat. They've been in meditation for so long. Who needs treasure? I don't even know what treasure you're talking about, honestly. That treasure, right? That was the treasure. Probably gonna fall out of the bottom floor, I'm sure. Here, is this what I'm supposed to do? It certainly seems like something I'm supposed to doing. Yeah, that's what I was referring to, Beard. Now, this wasn't so bad, actually. I thought that this was not going to end well. Thought it would take me a lot longer. I suppose it could have if Nathan didn't help me. Oh, that one. Yeah. I don't even know what was in it, to be honest. I never really find them. I know I got it my first time, but I never really find... Like, I don't ever feel I'm rewarded when I go for the chests. Unless that one is potentially... That could be something really awesome. You're like, oh, what are you doing, dude? See if I can remember how to do this one. I don't know how all of you guys feel, but I also personally feel that this was the one that gave me the most trouble. In fact, the last one I did, I think the camel was the last one I did. I thought that one was like super easy. Is that the one with like the wind puzzle? Is that the camel? Or maybe it's on the volcano. Whatever one with the wind puzzle, I thought that one was pretty easy. Yeah, that running out of arrows happens to me quite often, honestly. So I know that there's... Yeah, see, I don't even... I have zero recollection of the camel puzzle. Then I can't remember the electric... Oh, wait. Yeah, actually, that one was kind of annoying, too. I thought the wind one was very, very easy, though. Or was it the bird? I think there was wind ones in the bird, but that was the one that, like, sent you up in the air and you had to use the, you had to use the glider a lot, right? I'm trying to remember how I do this. But I'm talking about the one, so like it would shift from side to side, and then there was like this, there was a hallway with this gust of wind that was going through. I think, no, it was the gecko. It is the gecko, because like, he moves and it like makes the whole arena sort of shift around. I hated all of them. I'm generally not a fan, honestly, of temples, all that kind of stuff. I'm really not much of a fan. I am, on the other hand, totally trying to remember how to do this one. See, you would think it's all the way down. I think that's the way it's got to be done. Go. Maybe if I glide. There was only a little bit of wind in it. AJ is right, is that there was a lot more wind in the other one. All right, Zillion, thanks for stopping by, man. There we go. Okay. Let's try it this way. Probably supposed to come up here. At some point, at least. Is it a drop down here? Certainly looks that way. Yeah, I think I know what I'm doing now. I think. Yeah, that was the electric one that people were talking about. I did actually find some of the electric puzzle to be really annoying, to be fair. There were a couple of parts of that really pissed me off. I got really lucky with the Switch Rad. I got extremely lucky with the Switch. We got it on launch, and it was day two, and for some reason, Toys R Us had decided that they were not going to... They decided they were not going to sell the Switch on day one, so instead they sold it on day two. Target had a few of them at the time, and my girlfriend tried to go to Target and grab us one and missed. And a bunch of the people, she had heard about the rumor of, all the way down? Is that what I'm supposed to be doing here? She had heard of the rumor that people were going to be, yeah, that looks like it's it. People were going to be going, or heard about the rumor of Toys R Us doing it on day two. So a bunch of the people that missed it at Target had all decided to go to Best Buy. And when I heard that, I was like, no, everyone's going to go to Best Buy. We got to go to Toys R Us. No one's going to think to do that. And I was lucky. We were right. We waited in line for about 2.5 hours, but luckily we were able to get our hands on it and very, very happy. Very happy with Switch. Yeah, it's a lot. I mean, it's too bad. 1-2 Switch should have come with it, honestly. I mean, the Wii U is basically... The Wii U copy is... It's not really all that different. It's basically the same thing. I mean, it was just ported over to the Switch, honestly. I'm really scared about this part, guys. I'm here. I know I'm here. I know this is it, but... Oof. I'm scared to make that leap. Oh, no! I totally did not save. Oh, you son of a bitch. Son of a beesh. Rip. That's totally fair. It's totally fair to want to wait. I understand that. Having like a YouTube channel and stuff like that, though, I felt it was probably a good idea to try to grab it right away. And I'm not too disappointed. Plus, I got Disgaea. I got Disgaea Complete from the Japanese store. That was totally cool. See, I was under the impression the Switch was pretty easy to get your hands on now. I'd heard more people had gotten them. I guess they sold, like, immediately. It was too soon. Luckily, it wasn't too hard to get right back here. Yeah, I mean, it's tough. It's also, like, tough to grow, so I knew that would be... being a smaller channel and having not taken this seriously for very long, I knew that having a Switch would give me a huge advantage, so I immediately jumped on it. I don't know why, by the way, I just used my absolute best food, because that was a fucking genius move right there. That's crazy. Yeah, AJ, you're totally right, man. They're doing good. They're doing very good. They're selling well. Good for Nintendo. Good on them. I'm almost positive. I don't even think that's a conspiracy. Hey, see you later, Batman. Take it easy, dude. Thanks for stopping by, as always, dude. It's always a pleasure having you in here. But I don't think it's a conspiracy at all. I think they straight up did that on purpose, and I think that was an extremely intelligent business move. I think it's pretty obvious. I mean, they easily could have had more than what they had. I mean, on the other side of it, you know, you do have to think that the Wii U was not exactly extremely successful, to be honest. So, I mean, it was a gamble, and it's really difficult to go, okay, this is what I'm, you know, this is going to be super successful, so let's just go all out and make a bunch of them. That's dangerous. So there is that side of it, but I think that especially with the second wave, they were like, wow, that worked really well. Like, let's make a very little amount the second wave, and we'll see how that does.
Just one terminal remaining.
I'm gonna jump down here, and that's gonna be over for me, guys. Wow, you got a random Nathan over on YouTube said that he got a random Switch sold by somebody else who accidentally ordered two, and they sold it to him for the normal price. You are really lucky, man. I'm extremely surprised that guy did not jack up the price and screw you over. Wow, $50 from Amiibo, that's crazy. Oh, thanks, Amber. There we go. And I'm guessing it's down here. If not, I'm just stupid. Let's see. Hey. Where is it? There she blows. Hello, hi. Yeah, the scalpers were bad. Scalpers were really, really, really bad. Is it? It's near $100? That's crazy. Wait. Hold on, guys. Gotta get this. We only get about 10 people on YouTube. I mean, I knew it was a good idea to go to Twitch, because it's obviously that's where a lot of the crowd was. So this is only my third Twitch stream, but definitely felt that was probably the best way to start going. I was just waiting for Twitch to increase the bitrate cap, you know? Like, before it was a lot lower, and I was so hung up on my video quality, because I had really good video quality on YouTube, and I didn't want to lose that, especially for people that I had gathered already on YouTube. And once Twitch had increased the bitrate cap, and good on you, Twitch, for doing that, it was kind of a no-brainer to head over there as well. $800. That's crazy, man. $800 for a Switch? That's nuts. Definitely not worth it. Don't do anything stupid like that, guys. That's crazy. How am I gonna do this? Didn't I... What more do you want from me, Zelda? I probably did this totally the wrong way then, right? Maybe?
You're all gonna laugh at me.
My YouTube channel. It's posted up there somewhere, but it's if you search Glory to Gaming on YouTube, you'll find me. I will be the first one that comes up on YouTube. Oh, hey, Nathan. Yeah, you can watch over here, too. You guys can watch wherever you want. That's totally why I do this. Hey, thanks, Corey. I appreciate it, man. What am I missing, guys? I'm apparently Zeltarded. What is going on? What? Oh, duh. 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 Now I feel so stupid. By the way, AJ, let it be known, I figured that out before you said it. Well, maybe not before you said it, before I saw you say it. Are we doing this wrong? Doing it wrong. Oh, okay, I see. I see. We're overextending here. Hey, welcome, Leroy. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, everyone, by the way. It's too many people to, welcome, my name. Hello, Maxim. Welcome over there. That's right. Axes can be fun. If you're watching Zelda. I the first time around, I think I found this one to be more annoying. But I also, I think that has a lot to do with this being my first one.
There should be a new glowing mark on your map. Head there. Be careful not to let your guard down.
So I'm being new to the Twitch community, I've actually had quite a warm welcome. I'm glad that I made the move to start doing the Twitch thing as well. Everyone that has been on here thus far has been super, super cool. Pretty lucky about that kind of stuff. I so rarely get anyone that's an asshole in any, like, either, you know, either on YouTube or Twitch. Everyone just seems to be super nice. I don't know, Amber's been around for a while. Amber, how often do you think we get someone that's, like, really an asshole? I'd say extremely infrequently. I think I've only had to ban maybe one person. Maybe one. Maybe two. Camel was such a pain in the ass, though. He really was. There were parts. It took me a little bit, but like the thing about the camel is that once the camel clicked, I was like, oh, okay, this totally makes sense. But it did take a little bit for that one to click. This isn't a bad one to do first. Yeah, everyone seems to be super cool. I have, like, no food, guys, so I don't know. Then again, when I fought the Lionel, I told everybody, I was like, I'm gonna get my ass kicked, and I beat him, I think, in, like, 3 tries. So I could be wrong. We'll see. We've gotten a few bots. Hey, you guys remember Chopper Guy? Who remembers Chopper Guy? Rest in peace, Chopper Guy. Cooking Mama, there you go. Aw, thanks, Leroy. I really appreciate that, man. That's really nice of you. Alright, you guys ready to laugh at me for getting my ass kicked? Because that's exactly what's about to happen. Yeah, I don't think we've banned anyone this season. I think everyone has been really, really cool this season. It's funny. This is interesting. So, in a Let's Play community, they were talking about how you basically can't take a break, and if you take a break as a YouTuber, that's it. Your channel dies, and you have to start all over again. And I told them the story of how I took a really long break, and I was fortunate enough that all of my hardcore fans all returned. And I mean, it was a long break. All of them came back, and everyone was like, dude, you were so, so lucky. I don't know what it is, kill it. Kill it with fire. It's over, guys. Oh, wait. You know what, though? So let's do this. Let's do this number. You got those lightning arrows, right? Does he not like lightning? I'd imagine he doesn't like lightning. I don't even know what you're talking about, Thunderblight. You're talking about the boss. I actually didn't struggle that bad with him. Yeah, but, well, I mean, unless you're talking about Admiral, but Admiral had stopped showing up for a while, so that was a long time ago. I think he'd probably stop coming back. Plus, I think Black Dragon also didn't come back for a while, but he was actually just in the stream today, so I'm fucked, guys. This is so bad. Hey, Redman, how's it going? No? Okay, yeah. Yeah, that worked out well. I was hoping, at least. God damn it.
Be cautious.
Oh, you think? You have a weakness or something? I'm screwed, guys. Like, I've got energy food. That's what I've got left. And I don't really want to, like, use up all my energy food on this guy. Honestly. That would make me very sad. Yeah. Yep. Kind of what I figured. I don't get it. I might actually have to leave in the house just to restock on food. Cause like I said, I'm going to be using pretty much just all of this stuff. No, I don't want to crouch! That's like, my one complaint with the Switch is, for anyone that doesn't have one yet, is that the analog sticks are fucking horrible. They really are. You might want to actually opt. Oh, now it's like it's tweaking out. You guys might want to opt if you get a Switch for the Pro Controller, like purely for that reason. Priceless maracas. Nice, dude. I don't think I have shit. We'll find out. Yeah, snails. Raw snails. That's the way to go, right? This, too. Listen, dude. I just need you to let me be. Oh, great. The sticks are horrible. They really are. You know, like, they're so small. The radius is very small, therefore they're extremely sensitive. And pressing them in to, like, crouch or something like that is way too easy to do. Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what I'm saying. Like, and that has killed me countless times. But you think that's bad. I don't know if any of you guys have tried the Splatoon 2. Wow, yeah, that's a great idea, Steve. Let's waste my arrows on nothing. But Splatoon 2 was awful. It was so hard. I had to turn my sensitivity all the way down. And, like, worse more... I'm not going to make it to end time. Worse more, it was, it starts off with motion controls, and it has, like, the worst motion controls I have ever tried, ever. Like, they are awful. I spent my entire first match, you know, totally making my team eat shit because I was standing there trying to figure out how to fix the controls. So basically, so the game is freaking playable. Oh. It probably is his weakness. Yeah, I mean, you're just gonna make him, like, fall down like that. Which I think that's probably how I did it. Also, I need this. This right here makes this a lot easier. Out of the water, please. See, that was my first Splatoon experience. And I had a lot of fun with it, actually. Hey, can we eat some guts? I'm worried, guys. This is where I'm starting to get worried. Balls. If it wasn't for food. If it wasn't for food. Seriously. Fuck! It's directly in their eyeball, you say? Steve, be cautious. I'll get it. I mean, I got pretty close that time. I was also being pretty reckless. Pretty. Let's see. First of all, we need this, because this is, like, the easier way to do it. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Keith Bar. By the way, I really like Keith Bars. That is probably my favorite candy bar in the whole world. I like how he does that. It's like, huh? Bomb arrows. You know, that's the trick. I mean, man, this is an adult channel. There's gonna be swearing, buddy. I wouldn't be here if you don't like swearing. I swear a lot more than I should. In fact, I try to tone down my swearing. It doesn't work. That's just how I am. I used to like Butterfinger a lot when I was younger, but it's just not my thing anymore. And as I was saying, bomb arrows, the Ganons, that's the trick, guys. Just load up on bomb arrows, and it's so easy to kill all the Ganons. That's how I kill most of them. This time around, I don't have one, unfortunately, so that's not going to happen. But... oh, good. I mean, I try not to swear too much. But I mean, if you watch any of my videos, I cuss literally the entire time. I'm just constantly cussing in my videos. I do my videos, man. Like, seriously, did you watch, in retrospect, episode 3. I swear almost every frame. Like, it makes me cringe how much I swear in that. I didn't even pick up on it while I was editing.
Careful, not much room to operate.
I'm not saying that there aren't, you know, just there aren't people out there that can swear more than me. I'm sure there are, but hey, ow! Sometimes I do find the camera to be a little bit cumbersome in this game. He's directly above me. This is really hard to pull off. Come on, dude. Oh, I rage when playing. I'm so bad. Poor Dr. Landmine. Poor guy. I fucking died again. I didn't heal. Poor Dr. Landmine. One time I just like flipped out on him. I had to stop playing Paragon. I take Paragon way too seriously. I had to totally had to stop. I remember Butterfinger BBs. Butterfinger BBs were dope. Those were so good. You can reflect his giant spear, that is... You can reflect... What do you mean? How would I do something like that? You think I should use that bow? The three arrow bow? Ooh. Hating Overwatch, that's dangerous. The dangerous thing to say. I really love Paragon, I do. I'm just, as much as I want to be so good at it, and I'm just not. No, I never parry. I really don't. I really don't. I mostly just died there just because I forgot to heal. Honestly. I mean, I could try it. I don't even remember how to parry, if I'm going to be honest.
Careful, that spear has a long reach.
But he went down pretty quickly. Alright, I gotta actually, like, try to pay attention to this. We got an art walk today. Go to. I'm having a lot of fun with Zelda. This is how I do bosses, guys. I just brute force them. Is it Shield the name? Yeah. Actually, Kayla brought up Paragon recently. She was like, "Hey, we should stream Paragon," and I was like, "I don't know." I get really angry when I play Paragon. Anything with Elo will just really, really make me extremely angry and rage. So I'm gonna try what someone suggested over here, and I'm actually gonna try it. You know, it does less damage though. Should I really pick the three bow if it does less damage? I've always hated these bows personally. Oh, wow, that worked really well. That was a good call. That worked extremely well. It's funny, because I'm generally not a huge competitive gamer, but there's something about, like, MOBAs, which I'm not gonna say I'm, like, the worst at them, but I'm not super great at them, and there's something about them that just make me rage so hard. It's easy to see how League of Legends has gotten a reputation for being a toxic community. I mean, like, those kind of games just kind of breed that. Hey, whoever said this bow, thank you. Thank you very much. That totally changed this around. 120%. Bye. Hey, Leroy, good job, bud. Thanks, man. That's the weird-looking one that I had, right? It was just slow. That's why I didn't personally want to go for it. You know, I feel like the one that I should have went for first, though, if I'm going to be honest, was the bird. Because the bird, after you beat the bird, you get the thing that, like, lifts you up in the sky. That is probably, for exploration, that is hands down the best power in the game. Hey, art container. One step closer to the Master Sword. I also can get another one once I leave. I gotta click on you again? No? We're done? Yeah, let's activate it. I did it first. I forgot my powers quite a bit at first, and then it got to a point, though, where I had used it enough and just realized, wow, man, I should really use this just, like, all the time.
Because of your courage, my spirit is now free. And Ruta...
Mipha, the hottest fish in the sea.
Thank you. For I am now allowed by this freedom to be with you once again. Since I am now a spirit, my healing power will be wasted on me. I have no need of it.
Look at that walk. Oh, she's just owning it, guys.
Please accept Mipha's grace.
I accept. Everyone wants to bang Link.
Yesterday, I was awash in a
yesterday.
Pool of tears. I had nearly given up hope and resigned myself to being
trapped into a Beatles song here.
As a spirit for the rest of eternity. But now you're here. All this time, my hope was to see you once more. Promise me that you will not hesitate to call upon my power if you ever find yourself in need. Knowing that will let my spirit rest in peace.
So I saw earlier, the Twitch crowd, I saw earlier that somebody had hosted me. I'm very, as I said, guys, I'm super new to Twitch. This is only my third Twitch stream ever. I used to only stream on YouTube. So I don't know if the person that hosted me is in this chat.
Farewell.
If you are, dude, thank you. Hats off to you, buddy.
Save Princess Zelda.
I really don't know how any of that stuff works. Nice. I'm so a Twitch noob. I really am, guys. You'll have to bear with me here as I learn the ropes over in your community. So far, my reception has been pretty good, though. Definitely not a decision that I regret whatsoever. From what I understand, though, it's pretty difficult to get partnered with Twitch. I think you have to have there's certain requirements you have to meet. I think that's where some of my hesitancy came from coming over to Twitch, because being already partnered with YouTube, I was like, well, made the leap though. Playing the Wii U? You and 68 other people play this on the Wii U. I'm just kidding, guys. Yeah, Switch is great. It's totally worth picking up. That's really cool. I didn't even know that was a thing, really. I wouldn't say this is the beginning of the game, Captain. I think this is my third elephant laser. I think this is my third one.
This is it. This will be our last chance.
So I would assume I'm about 6 hours into the game, which is still really, really early, because I think by the time I had finished the last boss on my first playthrough, I would think I was 72 hours into the game.
And mine will be fulfilled.
This game has a crazy amount of content.
Father, are you well, I wonder? I want you
honest to God, I know I'm going to get shit. Someone's going to give me shit for this, but honest to God, I think that this is authentically one of the best video games ever made.
I wish I could see you again. Even just once more.
I'm not sure I want to know. You can find out, and I'll show you guys. A lot of people don't know this. So it does clock it for you, but it didn't show up till about 50 hours of gameplay. So for me, so 70 hours more. That's my main account. I'm using my Japanese account right now so that I could start over and not get rid of my current progress. But it does actually show you eventually. Apparently it's kind of wonky and doesn't really show up right away. Yeah, it's huge. It's huge. The art style is so good. I think that was really a big part. I think that was really a big part of one of the best decisions they possibly could have made, because I think that the art style is really timeless. I think that over the years, this game is going to age incredibly well. I think the Wii U does tell you straight up. I've never played a Xenoblade before, but I'll tell you what, man, I will pick it up. I'll start streaming this. That will be my first Xenoblade that I play. I played Xenogear way back in the day. I have no idea if those things are even related, but Xenogears was an excellent RPG. I believe it was a Square Enix RPG, PS1 era, and it was awesome. Also had, it had like mech thingies and stuff. Really good. Are they related? I don't know. It's crazy, man. Like, I remember that exploring the map as I was playing through it my first time. I would like open up a zone and I'd look at my map and I'd be like, how the hell are there still 5 more zones for me to explore? Like, that's insane. Authentically, I think this is probably one of the biggest maps I've ever seen. This map's huge, at least for like this type of game. I'm on Switch. Hey, it's fine. Don't worry about it. I won't go into too much because I already said it for the people that are watching, but the Switch is very, very good. It's very good. And if you're looking for a convenient console, it's an excellent one to pick up. Oh yeah, now you're eating your words, aren't you, buddy? Muzu, what an asshole. I think the Switch is an extremely innovative console, and I haven't really been huge into a Nintendo console since the GameCube. Just a long time ago. That was the last time I was like, man, I love Nintendo. Oh, the Master Sword. It does look amazing. Yeah. Seth, I'm not exactly sure that it's fair to say that Link got the princess killed, but yeah.
Yeah.
It is believable. I think it's funny because, I mean, obviously they're not human, but I think that it's also a very human reaction to have in general. Something sometimes obviously when things are like out of our hand, it's really easy to sort of to put the blame on another person, and I think that obviously makes it extremely relatable. So it's a good move. Who's it still a dick? Alright, yeah! What's in here? Hey, someone just said something about that, didn't they? Alright guys, so this has been a really great stream. Actually, you know, all of my streams lately have been really good. I feel really blessed about that because everyone that has been coming in here has been really, really, really awesome. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me and spending time. Unfortunately, I need to end the stream here, and that's because I own obligation to take my girlfriend out on an art walk. I'll probably be returning later, and there's definitely a lot more Zelda to come. If you're on Twitch, come check us out on YouTube, Glory to Gaming on YouTube. And if you're on YouTube, come check us out on Twitch. We're new on Twitch over here, so that's cool. And of course on YouTube, you know, do the like thing, do the subscribe thing, and over on Twitch, I don't know what you Twitch guys do, but do what you Twitch guys do. I'll see you all soon. Take it easy.